Hi, this is Arna from the TARS team, and today I'm going to show you guys how you can build your very first high converting chatbot using the TARS builder. The first step that you want to take to build your chatbot is go to our website, hellotars.com. It's what you're seeing on your screen right now. And if you haven't already done so, sign up for the builder. There's a sign up button in the top right of the screen. Once you click the sign up button, there's going to be a pretty standard looking sign up form. Give us your email, give us your name, choose a secure password, and give us your phone number because that helps us give you a better customer service experience. Hit the green create my account button, and then that's going to initialize your account. It's pretty much like every other sign up experience you've ever experienced on the internet. Once you sign up, it's going to drop you directly into the chatbot templates section of the builder. Over the last couple of months, we have spent a lot of time curating hundreds of chatbot templates to make it easier for you guys to create your own chatbots. These chatbot templates are organized by industry and use case, as you can see by clicking the dropdown in the top right of the screen. And essentially the way they work is, say you are looking to create an auto loans chatbot. You come into the chatbot template section, you see that there's an auto loans chatbot over here, you click on it, that drops you into the information page for the chatbot where you can interact with it, see what questions it's asking. If it's asking a similar set of questions that you want to ask in your chatbot, you can click the green use this template button to clone that exact same bot into your account, where you can make changes to it so that it's optimized for your business. So you can go in, change the company name, add your branding, change the way the bot looks, maybe add a couple of extra details that you're looking for so that it's optimized for your business. In this video though, I'm gonna focus on creating a chatbot from scratch because you need to know the basic mechanics of the builder even if you're editing a template like this one. So to do that, what I'm going to do is first, I'm going to select the TARS button at the top of the screen. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on that. That is going to drop me into the My Chatbots section of the builder. So as you can see on the left side of the screen, there's a menu. There's the Chatbot Template section, and above that, there's the My Chatbot section. That's where we are right now. Over here, you can see all of the chatbots that you've created so far. So I just cloned the automotive loans chatbot, and that's there right over here for me to edit whenever I want to. If I want to create a chatbot from scratch though, I'm going to click the blue create a chatbot button. That's going to open up this little modal over here where I can select create from scratch on the left side of the screen. Once I hit create chatbot from scratch, it's going to open up the creation workspace where I can define the messages that the chatbot says, check the data that's being collected on the back end, configure the chatbot's webpage, essentially just set up my chatbot so that it's ready to use in my marketing campaign. By default, the creation workspace when you create from scratch is empty, as you might expect. And the first thing that you want to do is populate that creation workspace with a gambit. So click the green add a gambit button in the top left of the screen. It's going to populate your canvas with an element that looks like this. This element is called a gambit, and it's the basic building block for a conversation. It's a single back and forth between the bot and the user. And the way it works is you define what the chatbot is going to say up here in these messages, and then you give the user an opportunity to respond with one of the user input UIs that we have. We have dozens of them. So if you want to collect calendar and time, if you're booking appointments, select calendar and time. If you want to give quick reply buttons, select buttons. This is a super popular one that I'll get to a little bit more in this video. Or if you want to collect plain old text, for example, if you're asking for someone's name, you can use text input. I'll leave a link to a help doc which explains what each one of these does in the top right of the screen. In this particular example, I'm going to walk you through the process of creating a very basic lead generation bot for a car insurance company. So what we can say is we can greet ourselves. We can say, hi, I offer car insurance. Give me a few details and I'll send you a quote. If I were an actual company, I'd probably put a lot more thought into this, but just for this video, I'm just gonna go through it really quick. Now let's ask them for the first detail. What is your name? To respond to that, I want to give users a simple text response, because you can't respond to a question about your name with a button, because there are hundreds of thousands, millions of names in the world. I'm going to rename the gambit to name so that it's easier for me to check the data once it's collected. And in the input type within the text input config, I'm going to select full name. This is going to verify that they're sending you a full name, not just a last name, not just a first name, a full name, so that you can create a complete file on this lead. Once you're done with that, hit the green save button like I just did in the top right, and then add another gambit to your creation workspace. Once you've added the other gambit, you will notice that there is a red socket at the top of that gambit, a red socket at the bottom of the previous gambit. And what you want to do is connect those together. So click and drag from the bottom socket on the first gambit to the top socket on the second gambit to connect them. Now what's going to happen is the bot is going to send these messages, the user is going to respond with their name, and then it's going to move on to the next gambit where the bot sends another set of messages, so asks for the second detail in the lead generation flow. So over here, let's ask them if they are a first-time car owner. So we can say, nice to meet you. Are you a first-time car owner? Are you a first-time car owner? Once the bot sends those messages, we want them to respond with a simple yes or no. We could give them text input, but it would probably be easier if we just gave them buttons that they could tap on and respond with a single tap. So let's give them two buttons that say yes and no. And let's rename the gambit to first time car buyer, something descriptive. Hit the green save button, and now you'll notice that there are actually two red sockets sticking out of the bottom of the second gambit. These red sockets correspond to the two button options that we gave, so yes and no, and they allow you to branch the conversation off in different directions depending on what the user responds with. So for example, let's say that for whatever reason, my car insurance company doesn't give insurance to first-time car owners. So if they say yes, we want to end the conversation and say that we don't give insurance to first-time car owners and they should try somewhere else. If they say no, we can collect their email and follow up with them later, so capture their lead. So let's create a couple of gambits, move them into position, and connect them up. So if they say yes, we'll take them over here, and if they say no, we'll take them in this direction over here. First, down the yes branch. So they've said that they are a first-time car buyer. We're going to close out the conversation. We can say something like, sorry, we don't give insurance to first-time owners. Please look for another provider. And now we can end the conversation by selecting auto page redirection from the user input type. It's all the way over here right at the end. Select auto page redirection, rename the gambit to something like end, and hit the save button. Now you'll notice that the red socket at the end of this is black in color. That indicates that the conversation has ended over there and no further messages are going to be sent. A really quick aside, you'll also notice that in the first gambit, the initial socket is black, indicating that this is where the conversation starts. Moving back to the lead generation flow though, if they say no, they're not a first-time home buyer, we can say, great, give me your email, give me your email ID, and I'll send you some more info. Let's put email verification on in the input type, rename the gambit to email so it's descriptive, and hit save. Now that we've captured their lead, we've got their name, we know they're not a first-time car owner or a car buyer, we have their email and we can end the conversation. So they've given us their email, let's say thank you, check your inbox, I'll send you the info soon. End the conversation over here, call it end, and select auto page redirection from the user input type and hit the save button. With that, we have a very basic lead generation flow created. We can hit the publish chatbot button in the top right, select launch landing page, using the button right next to the publish button. And that's going to open up the bot in a new page where you can interact with it, see how it's performing, see whether it's working the way you want it to. And in the case that you're ready to actually distribute it, you can actually use the link over here and share it with people as a landing page, just like this, where they can share their lead information. Now, there's a lot more to this builder. You'll notice that this is a very bare bones sort of chatbot. It looks pretty generic. The URL is generic. And you might be wondering where all of this data is going. So let's get into that real quick. So let me just share my email really quick. So let's give it my email. And let's switch back to the builder. Now, within the builder, you'll notice on the left side of the screen, there are a whole bunch of other menu options. In the configure menu, you can define what the URL will look like over here. So over here, it just says chatbot.hellotars.com. You can change that to carinsurance.hellotars.com to make it customized to your company's name. You can change the bot's name. So car insurance, lead gen, let's call it something basic like that. You can go into page settings and change the favicon. So what appears in the tab up here, what the meta image is, and do a whole bunch of other cool stuff like that. There are also email notifications set up. So by default, every time someone has a conversation with this bot over here, your email account will get an email, and you can also add other email accounts over here. So I can add my colleague's email account, for example, if I want him to get the email notifications as well. And in the analytics and tracking section, if you use Google Analytics or Facebook Pixel or Google Ads conversion tracking, you can add your IDs over here so that your bot is hooked up to those services. In the design section, you can define how your chatbot is going to look. So we can change the bot message bubble color to maybe red, the user message bubble color to maybe green, make it Christmas themed, hit the green save button at the bottom left, hit publish and open it up again. And now you'll notice that the chatbot has completely changed in the way it looks. In the distribute and share section, you can define how you're going to distribute and share it. So it gives you the link which you can share with people. You can embed the chatbot as a widget into your website. It'll be in the bottom right corner. Or you can deploy it onto your domain as a standalone page so that the URL is actually your own URL up here. Now, for the most important part of this menu on the left, the check data section. If you select check data, you will see four options on how you can actually access your data. Starting from the top, if you click on view, you just see reports of every single conversation that your chatbot has had. So over here, let's give it my name again. This conversation over here is going to get logged in that view section as well. So over here, if I refresh the data, you'll see that there are two conversations, the one that I had before and the one that I started just now. This allows you to look at the nitty-gritty details of each chat conversation that your bot is having. But if you're interested in seeing a more bird's eye view, bird's eye view statistics about how your chatbot is performing, you don't want to see the individual reports, select analyze, you'll be able to see a couple of statistics about your bot. So how it's interacting with users, whether it's interacting with them, whether it's converting users, whether it's capturing their email ID. If you select timeline graph on the left, you'll be able to see how these statistics change over time. Right now, the bot has only collected two conversations, so it's not really showing anything here. But as it collects more leads, you'll be able to see those statistics over here. If you use a CRM, select the integration section. You'll be able to use our Zapier integration. We have a tutorial video over here to send the chatbot data directly to your preferred CRM. In the export section, if you're a real data nerd and you like to play around with your lead generation data in Excel, you can select export your chatbot data as a CSV, and play around with it in Excel. That's pretty much it in terms of what you need to know to build your first chatbot, configure it, and check the data that's being collected on the other end. If you have any more questions for us, feel free to reach out to us on Intercom. There is a widget in the bottom right corner of the screen in the builder, and we have customer support representatives who are more than happy to walk you through any problems that you have. We're really excited to see what you can create with this builder.